98online.com/livewire.
All right, let's get to it. 98online.com. There is our Harlem Shake.
Controversy afoot.
Oh yeah.
Controversy.
In the general crotchal region is where the controversy is. Josh Spiegel feels that he was sexually assaulted during the making of that Harlem Shake video that we did at Ski Liberty. There was a gentleman who may have had one too many and got up next to him.
There was some vigorous dry humping.
Yes. And there was groping.
There was a groinal squeeze.
I was sexually assaulted.
We put a poll up yesterday. We had listeners go and look at the actual video because there is evidence.
Yep.
And 70% of our listeners agree with Josh that he was sexually assaulted.
That's crazy.
Now we need a professional opinion.
I'm sorry. We're going to get Darren on the phone, but does it bug you that I know you think you were sexually assaulted, and if you truly believe that, then I'm watching a video of you being sexually assaulted.
That is correct.
Does it bother you that I think the video is hilarious?
Yes, it does. It bothers me a lot.
Because it's hilarious.
Admittedly, Scott did bring in childhood poetry of his entitled Chandeliers of Blood, if I'm not mistaken.
No, yeah. So one poem where
you're a little left
to
center, okay? You're a little left
to
center.
But when you start yelling cut, go to the website. It's on the morning show page. 99. Cut!
I had enough.
Yeah, take your earmuffs off.
Instead of punching the guy in the face or saying, get the hell away from me, he took it out on Johnny Rose, our director.
And Chiquita watched it last night, and she was like, oh, he's having like...
a hardcore time, yeah.
No, like one of those like celebrity moments. Like you had like a Christian Bale moment. Like if you really take a step back, this is like...
it was not a celebrity moment.
And he goes up to the camera, he's like, take your earmuffs up. Yeah, can you tell them...
Okay,
I'm
going to my trailer.
Here's
the thing. No.
And he's like having a...
The thing was, I was under the impression that I was just supposed to stand there by myself, seriously, while everybody acted crazy. So when that wasn't happening and I was being assaulted, I wanted to bring that to the attention of people who were, directing it or not directing it. You know, people who are watching. Because I thought that situation needed to be fixed. That had nothing to do with celebrity.
Now, was this a crime of opportunity, or do you think you were sought
now,
out?
Now, the other thing is...
I didn't say it. That was what my
wife... Now, the other
wife,
thing is, we posted the question, was Josh sexually assaulted or not on 98online.com? More than 70% said yes.
Yeah.
So we said, okay, let's get a lawyer on,
our lawyer.
And to tell us if it was actually a sexual assault.
And joining us on the phone is Darren Kaddish, our unofficial... Attorney General here at 98 Rock. How are you, Darren?
Hey, I'm good. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. Now, yesterday you sat down, you spent some time with the video. How many times do you think you watched it?
I don't know, 50, 60 times.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
You have to slow it down. You got to pause it. You got to rewind it. You got to make sure.
Overall, what'd you think of the video?
Frame by frame, Scott. Frame by frame.
Yeah.
Overall, what'd you think of the video, Darren?
Well, first I had difficulty figuring out anything happened to Josh because I saw him bouncing up and down, and then I realized that was a giant poster in the back.
Yes. Come on now.
Yeah, that was not him.
Come on.
Yeah, but then you...
Once I realized he was in the crowd.
Yeah, right.
I did review it, and of course I had to pull out the book and look through all the arcane laws that we have in the state of Maryland.
Oh, you pulled the books out and everything.
Wait, but there's a twist to that, but go ahead.
I see two potential criminal actions.
Here we are.
And one potential legal action, which would be civil in nature.
Oh, money. What's up?
So, I don't know how you want me to break it down first.
Well, let's
hey,
go
you're in charge. Yeah, let's
go over the three possibilities.
Yeah, please.
Look at the smile crawl across Josh's face right now.
Yes.
You heard civil.
Possibility number one.
Yeah.
Plain old assault. Assault is not defined in the code. It's something we learn in law school. It's basically what's called an unprivileged touching.
So okay, that technically...
Or an offensive touching, meaning it's offensive to the person being touched.
So just to be clear, Darren, I was assaulted.
Well, it's in Maryland it's called assault, but that includes what's actually the common law crime of battery.
Okay.
So you weren't actually assaulted because the technical definition of the common law crime of assault is that you were placed in imminent fear of harm.
Yes.
You weren't assaulted, but under Maryland code... both a battery, which is the touching, and the assault, which is the fear, are called assault.
Right.
Okay?
Christ, you're
under
smart.
The statute. Yeah. So what happens is you were actually battered. Okay?
It was battery.
Or allegedly battery.
Yeah,
okay.
And that's the whole thing.
Allegedly. Offensive or unprivileged touching of another.
Right. Okay, but then you're saying allegedly battered, but there's video evidence. So based
I'm
on the video.
I'm going to get to all this. Let's just roll through. Don't rush him, Scott.
I'm just saying there's proof there. What does the video say?
Well, if I say this is going to be the same answer for all three.
Oh, okay. He's dragging this out. He's paid by the hour. He's dragging this out. It's going to be a 2-hour explanation. Going to get a bill for $500.
Go ahead.
Number two. So that's the plane crime. Then there's the sexual crime. Now, sex crimes are defined a little differently. Sex crimes, because there was no actual, and I'm going to be very careful in my choice of words.
Okay.
They're coming right from the statute. I don't want to get dumped.
Use the word junk.
the other gentleman's junk. Okay, appeared to be rubbing on Josh's leg.
Right.
Okay?
Yes.
That would be what's called sexual contact.
Okay.
Because it does not involve certain things which are required under the statute for sexual assault or sexual acts.
Aha!
So there's a distinction between sexual acts and sexual contact.
All right.
Okay? Now, because there's no force or threat of force that I could see in the video, it's clearly limited either to a third-degree or fourth-degree sex offense.
Bringing what type of punishment with it should it be proven guilty?
Yeah.
Well, let's see. A third-degree would be a felony with up to 10 years in prison.
Whoa! Damn!
Yeah! You're going to fry, bitch!
And a fourth-degree is a misdemeanor with 1 year or a $1,000 fine.
Okay, so
but I don't believe it's third degree.
I was unsure because one of the
criteria for third degree is either it's teacher student or something like that, or engage in sexual contact with another if the victim is a mentally defective individual.
Josh, totally counts.
So I immediately thought we'd really have to have Josh evaluated, and then we could determine. But clearly, a sexual offense in the fourth degree, which is just the simple contact.
So now we should say this guy's probably in Mexico now.
Well, no, he's in Pennsylsylvania, and that's where all of this went down.
No, I mean, he has fled
to Mexico. The civil charge would simply be a charge for battery, which is the simple tort. And that's pretty simple.
I want to be clear. Should we take this to trial?
I don't want this guy to freak out. Do you think you'll lose if you put
Josh on the stand?
I'm sorry?
Yeah, you think you'll lose to a jury if you put Josh on the stand?
If he's so unsympathetic as a victim?
If I'm the defense attorney, I'm going to blow up the video.
Right.
Because remember, the common law definition of battery is offensive touching. And when the gentleman is humping Josh's leg, and here's why I believe he would lose. There's two reasons.
Who would lose?
Josh or the defendant?
Josh.
Oh, okay.
He's smiling.
Yeah.
He appears to be enjoying it.
Oh, yeah.
How offensive was the touching?
Oh, yeah.
Was he asking for it? That's what we want to know.
But it was... Darren, how can you prove that the smiling... How can you prove that the intent of the smiling was happiness?
If I'm the... And the second...
There was smiling!
...reason is when the video ends and Josh yells, cut, he doesn't yell, cut, I've just been assaulted, or I've just been... He yells, cut, I'm not supposed to be involved. I'm supposed to be standing still. His first complaint is not about the alleged criminal act or battery, which was just performed upon him. It's concern about his role in the video.
So it wouldn't hold up in a court of law. He would lose. He's freaking out over nothing. Darren, we've all seen worse on dance floors and nightclubs, let's be honest. I mean, we have. There's dudes that dry hump the hell out of chicks on a dance floor, and it does nothing, you know. It's in your expert opinion, upon first, second, third view, before you dissected it, were you just like, what is this?
Besides frivolous?
What's
frivolous.
That?
Frivolous?
Oh, wow. Well, it is, okay. Oh. So we're all, it's frivolous. You were smiling. You didn't complain about a sexual assault.
I was smiling because I was uncomfortable.
A child being tickled relentlessly smiles.
Josh,
that would hold up if he said that.
That could absolutely hold up, and that's why we have judges and juries. And, and the person could make a determination for themselves if you had a judge or a jury trial.
There'd be a plea bargain anyways, and they would plea bargain down to the misdemeanor fourth degree.
Here's the other thing, though. You have to remember that there's another little twist here, which is that...
It was in Pennsylvania.
The sex crimes and assault crimes are what's called... I believe the sexual contact crime, excuse me, not the general assault crime, is a specific intent crime because it involves attempted gratification.
Ah.
Well, so, there's another angle based on exactly what you just said. Josh brought to light that this gentleman approached him with intent before the video got started.
Yeah, he said some things.
Looked
to him.
At Josh and said, and I quote,
I'm gonna
bend you over and bang the hell out of you.
Well, that's terrific. The problem The problem with specific intent crimes is, first of all, that gentleman looks familiar. I think I've seen him at some events, number one.
You probably defended him.
But number two, he was probably obliterated.
Right.
And there are cases that say that intoxication can prevent people from forming the requisite specific intent to commit a crime.
Right, I wasn't thinking
because
clearly.
Because there's the mental element called the mens rea, which is a necessary element of every crime, and in specific intent crimes, you have to have that specific intent.
God, he's so smart.
Note to self, if you're going to rob a liquor store, get drunk first.
Now, is the fact that, like, we were filming a video where everybody was supposed to be a little bit raucous, like, does that, maybe he was just acting?
Well, I'd accept that, except for the fact that Josh said he came up beforehand and warned him of his
which
doesn't mean he's not obliterated.
What is the bottom line? So what, in your opinion, let's not talk about if it could be proven in court.
Okay.
In your opinion, as an attorney, was a crime committed? And was a sex offense committed?
In the overall circumstances of what I saw, no. Because, again, this is a video where people are told in these memes to act crazy
and be wild,
and he's playing a part. So
that's what I just
actors
said.
That hit each other in the movie don't commit crimes.
There it is. Well,
what the hell do you know?
Well,
Darren,
I think he just proved what he knows.
You're the man, buddy. We thank you again.
I want a second opinion.
All right, well, you do it on your own time.
For the bending over.
Do it on your own time. We're done.
Thank you.
Thank you for clearing the air, Darren Kaddish. Where can people find you?
They can find me at Facebook/98RockAttorneyGeneral, and they can find me at www.avvo.com and see my attorney listing.
There it is. You're the man, buddy.
All right, thanks. All right,
bye, Darren.
God, that was good.
Man, he's smart.
He's really smart. God, he's smart.
I was assaulted.
No,
okay.
You weren't.
Yes, I
you
was.
You got to put it to rest.
You got to let it go.
You were being a C-tease.
He just said no.
You can go to
there
counseling.
There was no crime committed.
Your health insurance will cover counseling.
I could find a lawyer who agrees with me.
Oh, I'm sure that will take all of your money. Oh, yeah.
Herschel Spiegel.
Are they dealing with Carnival Cruise victims?
Yeah, don't you have an uncle somewhere or something?
No, I don't.
The 98 Rock Morning Show with Mickey, Amelia, and Spiegel. 98online.com.